No, wait, yes.
What up, everybody? It's Rana with the figure review on this Gundam MSIA Red Frame Gundam. Now, wow. Seriously, man, this Gundam is legit. It is so cool. I said in my blog that there's a couple other videos of this figure out on YouTube, so be sure to check those out. But, I was kind of sad because, you know, they never showed everything. And mostly what I mean by that is they never really showed the beam sabers, which look like this. You know, right there. There's two of these. So, yeah, I'll get back to that when the accessories. So, they don't show that off, but I think this deserves to show off everything. So, we'll get to the hands. He has trigger hands right there. Two just sword grasping hands. And though I don't like these, but you know, they're included. Two closed fists. For punching, I've never been a fan of, I like these fists the most. You know, you can hold guns and the shield. So let's zoom out a bit. Just really cool. Now here he is, the red frame. He has his shield. Let's see. Plugs into there, and he can hold it in his hand. Now mine, I gave it my extra strike gun or beam rifle. The one it has in the manga is supposed to be different. I don't know. I never read the manga, so I can't tell you what it looks like. But I just, whenever I play with my red frame, I just give it this. But like I said, here are the swords, the beam sabers. They're really long. They're actually, I believe, longer than his Gabara straight. I don't know. But, you know, take out his hilt right here. And you just plug it in. You know, you guys know how these work. And yeah, really cool. And you can hold it. So let's move this out of the way of his hand and give it to him. So yeah, see. So that's something that I always thought was crazy, that side by side comparison, that these are a little bit taller or bigger, longer. This one's bigger. I mean, it looks cooler. So yeah, let's put these away. So yeah, it's two of those, and it just fits in back here. Let's take off the shield. You can kind of see it resembles the strikes a lot, but where the strikes is red here and yellow here, it's, you know, red and black. But it looks so cool. Just looks normal. This is on a ball joint. Looks so cool. And this thing, man, you can take this out. There's a peg here, and you can actually slide this off, so you can take that off and put it back on either side. But it looks, you know, that's where it's supposed to be. But yeah, whoever had this before me, I bought this on eBay, and they, I believe, panel line bits and parts of it, like the legs mostly, the swords. So if you're watching this, thanks, dude. I'm gonna make sure I keep this in good condition, and you know, you kept it in good condition too, keeping it 100%. So here's the sword, man. Some nice detail in there. The katana, or the Gabara straight. I'm gonna keep saying Gabara. Yeah, look at that. Is nice. Nice coloring. Yeah, that just slides right in there. Now, he's a really tight figure. I mean, his joints are really nice. Even though he doesn't have double joints, his joints have a good range. Like, here's his arms. They go that much, but it's only one joint. That's one joint going all the way. He has ball joints right here. The ball is on the wrist, so that has that range of motion. Shoulder goes all the way back, goes up and down, and see, it's like a ball joint. So he has a swivel at the bicep. The shoulder has its own kind of little movement. These are cool. Show more detail while I'm going with articulation, but yeah, see vents there. This turns a little. You can actually remove this, and I think the idea was for the that big triangle arms thing that becomes like a sword that the blue frame uses, I guess, or the Mars jacket for him, you know. I only get my information from Gundam Wiki or whatever, but still. So that would have been so cool if they created like those add-ons, you know, you can just take this off and then put it. That would have been cool. But that's like on a ball joint. Doesn't really turn, but when it does, it looks kind of awkward. So yeah, you know, same motion on the other arm. Head basically is that up and down, side to side. These beam saber handles seem to come off a lot. See, there's like little boosters. I don't know but what they are. I think they're boosters. Back of the head, and there's the back camera. The cameras are green. Waist doesn't really move. I mean, you could get it to, but you're a lot. You're just forcing. Doesn't stay, but there's little movement. And then it go. That's really far there. It doesn't really have side skirts, so he can really kick. So yeah, you can just have him like that, you know. And he goes far back too, because like I said, he doesn't have skirts. So now he's, the red frame is the total ballet. Now here's where it gets weird. Now the knee joints are single, so this is as far as it'll go by itself, but it'll go more. Like, you can go like that and just leave it there, but the thing is, it's not connected. It gets stuck, but it just, it's weird. Like, I don't know. It's one joint, which is just right, kind of right here. You see, and then it moves, but like I said, that's as far as it'll go by itself, and you can see it connects like that at the knee. Then he has that ball jointed feet. So yeah, the red frame. It's kind of expensive now. I mean, I on eBay, man, I was lucky to get at the price I got it for, considering that they go for, especially 100% complete, they go for like $60 now. So I'm very happy with my purchase. And if you have the chance, or if you have this figure, you know, enjoy it, you know? This figure is tight, and let me just get them in how I always do it. I'm gonna maybe make a little mini series with him, rename him instead of Red Frame, call him the Ronin Gundam. I don't know what I'm gonna do, but I love playing with this guy. So this is what I usually have him in when I'm just like not messing with him. Yeah, thanks for watching. That's my review. Peace.